Hi, everyone, and welcome to Gregg Doucette News, your one and only news source for all things Gregg Doucette. And we have a breaking news story for you today. Gregg Doucette is a fake natty? We're going to go live to our reporter in the field, Ollie. Ollie, tell us, has Gregg Doucette been lying about his natural status?
Yes, thank you, Richard. Now, as many of you may already be aware, Gregg Doucette is well known for his videos exposing fake naturals in bodybuilding and powerlifting. But, as it turns out, Gregg was once himself a fake natural. This reporter recently discovered documents proving that Gregg Doucette was knowingly taking performance-enhancing substances while competing in natural, drug-tested powerlifting. I suppose now we know why his detractors refer to him as Gregg Doucette.
So after Gregg Doucette has accused so many people of being fake natties, it turns out that Gregg Doucette himself has been one of the first fake natties in the fitness industry. So Gregg Doucette has actually talked about this on his own channel. He admits to getting busted for taking steroids in a drug-tested powerlifting meet back in 2009. And Gregg maintains that this was an accident. He unknowingly took steroids. I'll play the clip where he talks a little bit about this.
In 2009, he fails a powerlifting drug test. Fails. He failed the drug test. So after 16 past tests in a row, he finally fails. So does that mean he was natural for those 16 previous ones? Or does it mean that he was probably on steroids for those 16. Well, in powerlifting, they stripped him of every single record he had ever made in his life. Even when he was 22 years old and passing all those drug tests he paid for, they stripped all the records, took out the Gregg Doucette records, I think there was 14, stripped them out, and all the new records were the next place guy, and they were all like 100 and something pounds lower in the bench press. Like, this Gregg guy was a freak in the bench. He was literally setting records by 100 pounds more than the second best guy. He went to IPF Worlds and got third, drug tested, obviously, in past. He went to the Pan American Games and won first place. He went to the Arnold Classic and was drug tested 2 days in a row, where he won the raw powerlifting meet. And then he won the equipped, where you wear like a bench press fancy shirt and all that stuff, okay? So he was drug tested 2 days in a row and passed all those tests. But what's really strange is that this powerlifting meet where he failed, he lifted like poop. He actually lifted way less than he did at all the other powerlifting meets that he had done where he'd been drug tested and passed. So it's very strange that he would fail the drug test, but yet be weaker. You would think, having added steroids or SARMs, whatever at this point, that his lifts would have gone way up.
So Gregg admits he was popped for steroid use during a drug-tested powerlifting competition back in 2009, but he says that it's a mistake. He didn't intentionally try to take like any performance-enhancing drugs. He's also really salty about being stripped of all of his records, and I was even able to find an old forum post on like a powerlifting forum where Gregg tried to defend himself, saying like, look, I obviously didn't, you know, take drugs throughout my entire powerlifting competition, so it's kind of stupid to get rid of all of my records. So I think Gregg is kind of full of crap. I think there's pretty damn good evidence to suggest he intentionally took performance-enhancing substances knowingly, and he just tried to get away with it. So first of all, not only did Gregg test positive for boldenone, also known as equipoise, as Gregg mentioned, but he also had a testosterone to epitestosterone ratio of 8-1. That's highly unusual. Most men have a testosterone to epitestosterone ratio of 1-1. So for each molecule of testosterone that your own body produces, you'll also produce another molecule of epitestosterone. So again, most men have a TE ratio of 1-1. For younger males, like going through puberty, you can see higher ratios, and there is some genetic variability, but most men have a TE ratio of 1-1. Gregg had a TE ratio of 8-1, 8 times higher than normal. pretty weird. So that's a very good indicator that he was taking exogenous bioidentical hormones. So basically injecting himself with testosterone. Because if you're taking in testosterone exogenously, like in a drug form, you're not going to produce epitestosterone to match the testosterone you're injecting exogenously. So you're going to have, you know, a very high TE ratio like Gregg had. And on top of that, Gregg said, he, in his defense, he tried to claim that he changed his supplements since the last drug test he took. So the one supplement he was taking was Pregnobolin. This is like a testosterone booster supplement. It's kind of weird that Gregg would take this in the first place because he's competing in a drug-tested powerlifting federation, and he's also doing natural bodybuilding at this time. And he's taking like a weird gray area supplement for, you know, test boosting. Kind of strange choice. Even if the supplement was dirty, I can't imagine how an over-the-counter supplement would make you have a testosterone to epitestosterone ratio of 8-1. Sounds a little suspicious. Even if the supplement was tainted with something, hard to imagine it giving you a TE ratio of 8-1. And Gregg also claims he was taking a supplement called Novadex, and he thinks this might have also given him a positive on his drug test results, even though he says he didn't knowingly take any drugs. Well, I searched Novadex, like I Googled it. I wasn't actually able to find anything called Novadex, but there's a bunch of different drugs with a very similar spelling. So I was able to narrow down two things that Gregg was probably taking or talking about here. So the first thing was called Nolvadex with an L. The generic name is tamoxifen, and this is a drug that's commonly used to treat estrogen receptor positive breast cancer. So basically, it just responds, it binds to the estrogen receptor in breast tissue, and it prevents estrogen from reaching that receptor, which hopefully will kill off or prevent cancer cells from, you know, growing and spreading. This drug is also sometimes used to treat gynecomastia. So you can understand why a bodybuilder like Gregg, who may have been injecting exogenous testosterone, who might have a lot of excess estrogen in his body from aromatization, would want to take a drug like Nolvadex, tamoxifen, to prevent estrogen from reaching the breast tissue, giving him, you know, gynecomastia. So that's one thing he could have been talking about here. A more likely candidate is Novedex, without an A, just E. It was created by Gaspari Nutrition, and it was actually recalled by the FDA in 2010 because it contained an aromatase inhibitor and steroids, so this actually fits with the timeline. So it looks like in all likelihood, Gregg was taking this back in 2009 when he failed his drug test, and I'll be perfectly fair and honest, so this was pulled off the market for containing steroids in 2010, so this would have been after Gregg failed his drug test, but Gregg would have known taking this even before then that this would make him pop on a drug test. He would have known that the ingredients in the supplement would not be okay in a drug-tested powerlifting competition. If you just look at any website that was selling the supplement at the time, they even flat-out admit in the description that this is an aromatase inhibitor. So that right there should have given Gregg red flags. Okay, this is an aromatase inhibitor. Obviously, something like this is going to be banned in a drug-tested competition. And if you look at the ingredients list, they flat out list the steroids and the aromatase inhibitors that are used in the product. You can even Google search this. You can look up the compounds. There's research papers on this. The one is a designer steroid. The other is an aromatase inhibitor. Clearly, this is just going to be banned in a drug-tested powerlifting competition. But Gregg took it anyway. Now, if we even give Gregg the benefit of the doubt, okay, maybe somehow in 2010, after the internet, you know, has existed for several decades, Gregg did not have the resources to look on the back of the package, you know, search the ingredients, look up what it is. Okay, imagine just finding a supplement in like GNC or some sort of supplement store, reading the back of the box, the label, and reading Andostra-3,5-DN-7-17-dione-3-B-hydroxy-andostra-1,4-6-trine-17-1. Honestly, do those ingredients sound like they're not performance-enhancing drugs? So even if we give Gregg the benefit of the doubt that somehow he did not have the resources to look up what these compounds were, as a drug-tested lifter, you think he honestly would take something like this in good faith? The Canadian Powerlifting Union, which Gregg competed under, they also have a website with a section that's dedicated to anti-doping, and they give you resources to check if certain drug or supplement or substance is under the banned substances list. And sure enough, if you put in some of the ingredients in that Gaspari supplement, Novadex, that Gregg was taking, yep, it's banned. So I don't know if Gregg would have had access to this resource back in 2009, but if he did, again, just proves my point further that, yeah, he took this knowing what it was. And even if Gregg didn't have access to this resource, he seemed pretty knowledgeable about drug use back in 2009, because Gregg made a statement where he showed he knows a lot about these drugs. I was extremely shocked by this news, as I knew it was extremely likely that I would be tested both in meat and out of meat, which makes knowingly taking a steroid that is detectable for 1.5 years simply absurd. Had I actually tried to artificially enhance my lifting, I would have used Anavar or Anadrol or something much more performance-enhancing. Considering I was dieting for most of the year, Equipoise would be the dumbest drug I could have taken. Dieting is hard enough without taking something that increases your appetite. So Gregg, even though he's a natural powerlifter, seems to know a lot about these drugs. So again, like, if he's gonna pick up something that has these weird freaking names on the back of the label, you'd think, like, again, he'd be pretty clued in into what it was, like, what it is, whether or not he should take it. So yeah, it seems like he knew what he was freaking doing. So I think with all this information, we can piece together what actually happened. I think Gregg was taking bioidentical hormones, so he was injecting testosterone, knowing that the powerlifting organization he was a part of didn't have the drug testing equipment to actually test if he was taking bioidentical hormones. They were just doing a simple testosterone to epitestosterone ratio test, which is very easy to pass even if you're on gear. I'll leave a link to a study in the description that talks about this. They were giving men high doses of testosterone and enthate, and despite that, they were still able to pass the testosterone to epitestosterone ratio test. The men on testosterone and enthate, they were getting a performance-enhancing benefit from it, but they were still able to keep their TE ratio below 4-1. And keep in mind, back in 2009, in Gregg's powerlifting organization, the cutoff point for, you know, a positive on a drug test was a testosterone to epitestosterone ratio of 6-1. So it's even easier for him to pass these tests. And since he's on testosterone, I'm sure he would be worried about aromatization into estrogen and developing something like gynecomastia. So I think he intentionally just found this Gaspari supplement, Novadex, and knew it contained an actual aromatase inhibitor, and he started taking it. I can't imagine any other reason why a natural powerlifter and bodybuilder, like, what business they would have taking an aromatase inhibitor. So I think he knew exactly what he was doing. Gregg seemed at the time to be very clued up onto what steroids do what, how to take them. So I think he was probably taking some testosterone. He found an over-the-counter supplement that just happened to contain an aromatase inhibitor that wasn't banned yet. And either the steroids he was taking, he was probably getting them off of the illicit market. Either they were contaminated with boldenone or the, you know, stupid over-the-counter supplements he was taking. Maybe those were contaminated with boldenone, and then he was surprised that it showed up on the test. Maybe he wasn't actually taking it, but just the stuff he was taking was contaminated with it. And keep in mind, actually in 2012, he was busted for drug dealing. He was selling steroids and smuggling them. So yeah, he was probably getting his steroids off of the illicit market, and they might have been contaminated with some other supplements, and then it ended up, you know, showing up on his test. So I think in all likelihood, that's what happened. Now, I know Gregg has a lot of fanboys, and I know they're going to tell me that a lot of this evidence is circumstantial, a lot of this is speculation on my part. I don't have any actual proof that Gregg took testosterone or willingly or knowingly took steroids. Well, I think we can all agree that we shouldn't trust people who are just liars, who have a long history and ongoing track record of lying. So this powerlifting thing, this was his first anti-doping violation, but it wasn't his last. Just recently, in 2018, Gregg entered a drug-tested bicycle race while on steroids. And Gregg still claims that he didn't do this knowingly. Again, he didn't do this knowingly. So Gregg claims that he didn't know this bicycle race was going to be drug tested, and if he did, he wouldn't have entered it. But this cycling organization, they were going to give him an 8-year ban, and Gregg actually went to an anti-doping hearing to get his like ban reduced or something. And yeah, unsurprisingly, he was caught lying during this hearing. So this is part of the full manuscript of what happened at this anti-doping hearing, and I'll leave a link in the description to the full manuscript, but I'm just gonna cover the most important parts. And what happened here was Gregg Doucette completed the race, and at the conclusion of the race, Mr. William Kohler, a DCO, which is a drug control officer, approached the athlete, Gregg Doucette. There's some disagreement about the details of the discussion between the drug control officer and Gregg Doucette, the athlete, but the following facts were not disputed. The drug control officer told Gregg Doucette that the athlete was selected to provide a sample as part of an anti-doping test. After some discussion, the athlete suggested that the two men move about 5 to 10 feet away to the side of the road, and they moved to the side of the road to continue the discussion. The athlete told the drug control officer that he would not provide a sample because he knew that he would test positive for testosterone. The drug control officer asked the athlete, Gregg, whether he had a therapeutic use exemption, and the athlete said that he did not. The DCO then suggested that the athlete take the test in any event, and the athlete still refused. The athlete signed the athlete refusal form. It is not clear whether the athlete signed a physical form or signed a form on a tablet, though little turns on the format. The athlete asked whether he was allowed to race the next day, and the DCO said that he was not in a position to tell the athlete whether he could race the next day. The athlete and the drug control officer talked for about 5 to 10 minutes in total. So again, they refer to Gregg as the athlete here, but Gregg's, like, one of his main arguments against this 8-year ban was that the drug control officer did not properly present himself as required. So Gregg's saying he didn't know who this drug control officer was. He could have just been some random person. That's one of the main reasons he didn't submit to this drug test. So if you scroll down, they actually proved that Gregg just flat out lied during this hearing. So the athlete, Gregg, argued that his compelling justification for refusing to take the test was that he believed that the drug control officer was not a proper drug control officer, and he was a creep, quote unquote. He testified that he did not trust that Mr. Kohler was a legitimate drug control officer and therefore did not want to go with him to give a sample. So I'm assuming this is a urine sample. The athlete had experiences in the past where strangers had suggested to him that they were a drug control officer but were not. That sounds like bullcrap. The athlete testified that he thought Mr. Kohler was talking with him because the athlete was a somewhat famous bodybuilder and was wearing a Superman shirt. So Gregg right here is claiming that a random guy wanted to just steal his piss because he likes his YouTube channel and he's a famous bodybuilder. Oh my God. Yeah, a random guy is just gonna try and steal your piss, Gregg, because they like your bodybuilding. The athlete also noticed that there was no race officials with the drug control officer. The athlete further argued that he thought that if the drug control officer were actually a drug control officer, the DCO would have told the athlete that he could not race the next day. So, this was their response. As stated above, I find that the drug control officer did have his identification documents around his neck. If an athlete is approached by an individual and asked to provide a sample, and if the athlete is concerned that the person asking is not a drug control officer, and that the person is a creep, quote unquote, the athlete would not and should not engage the person in a 5 to 10 minute conversation. The athlete would not tell the person that he or she takes testosterone and would fail a doping test. The athlete would not ask the person whether the athlete was able to race the next day, the athlete would not talk to the person about TUEs, and the athlete would not sign a form confirming the refusal to provide the sample. Those actions and comments are consistent with an athlete who believes the person asking for a sample is a legitimate drug control officer. So this is why I don't trust Gregg. He is a complete liar. He'll lie whenever it suits him, even when it's like these very unimportant situations, like, okay, getting banned from a bicycle race. Whoop-dee-doo, the guy isn't a professional cyclist. He just does it as a hobby, and he's going through the trouble to go to a hearing and lie for no real reason. The guy claims, oh, I didn't want to hand in, you know, a piss sample to get drug tested because I didn't think that guy was an actual drug control officer. But yeah, the people at the hearing said, you're full of shit. You talked to the guy for 5 or 10 minutes. You gave him your information. You signed forms. You asked him if you could race the next day. Clearly, you knew the guy was a drug control officer. Gregg is just a liar. I don't trust him. When there are circumstances like this where he gets busted for taking steroids, when he has a testosterone to epitestosterone ratio of 8 to 1, he's full of shit, man. He was on steroids then, and he's still lying. To this day, he still lies like this. Check out my Worst of the Fitness Industry video on Gregg where I expose more of his lies. The dude is just a liar. Don't trust him. When he was competing as a natural, he was a fake natty dude, and that makes it all that more hypocritical of him to call out these fake natties. I swear the majority of his videos on his channel now are fake natty videos. Well, Gregg, you're the OG fake natty. Who the hell are you to criticize any of these people? And if you like this video, maybe consider supporting me on Patreon or through my website. I have some funding perks you may find interesting. If you're looking for clothing, then check out the Vegan Gain store. And if you're looking for vegan pet food, then check out Vigor. They have a wide selection of vegan cat and dog food. And if you click the link in the description and use the discount code, you can get 10% off of any order. And if you're looking for online coaching, then check out Quality Gains. He offers customized meal and training programs. And if you click the link in the description, you can get a free ebook. And of course, check out my wife on OnlyFans. She does full nude. She's hot as hell. So if you're into that sort of thing, check out her OnlyFans. And of course, check out my OnlyFans. So if you want to see me naked, you want to see my pee-pee, check out my OnlyFans. And as always, keep making those vegan. And Gregg Doucette is a fake natty games.
What a relief. When will this poisonous product cease? This is another public service announcement. You can believe it or you can doubt it. Let us begin now with the cow. The way it gets to your plate and how.